fashion rules again. Yeah, yeah. Ooh, I'm aching all the time. Hey, you, yeah. After all the success we enjoyed in the United States, and we wanted so bad, we wanted to go to America, to rock America like a hurricane. We did. But to go to Russia at the end of the 80s was so much deeper in a way, and so much more emotional. And those days in Leningrad, I think it was an unforgettable experience that had a deep impact.
I think the main force really for Russia was Rudolf Schenker, who was keep telling us, oh, we have to go to Russia, you know.
Since 82, I was talking to the band. I said, look, guys, we have to play in Russia. The guys are looking at me and said, Russia? What do you want in Russia? Because Russia, there is no record company. There is nobody where we can play. There is the border and stuff like this. I said, but, you know, I think that the possibility, sooner or later, what do we have to make this here in our mind happening?
We wanted to go east. We knew we had fans in the Soviet Union. I mean, we had big songs like Rock You Like a Hurricane, like Still Loving You. We knew that there was a black market for music, and fans were traveling hours and hours on bus or trains to get hold of the music, you know, to listen to some Western rock music.
In 1986, we played a short tour in the summer called The Monsters of Rock. And we played also in a festival situation in Budapest, Hungary.
We met the guy who was the producer for the show in Hungary, in Budapest. Laszlo was his name. So we had a dinner with him and asked him, where's the Iron Curtain? And Laszlo said, the Iron Curtain is not exist anymore here in Hungary. We do already business with the West, and we are fine with that and stuff, you know. Because I said, we want to play in Russia. So he said, in Russia, it's also no problem. You guys have a big hit in Russia. You know that? We said, what? Big hit? Yeah, we're still loving you. It's big there, over there. Finish your new album, Savage Amusement, and then I will make it happen.
I remember there were like various people, some from a radio station, other people coming to Stommeln into the studio during the production. And so like very slowly, there was something that was built in terms of how to get to Russia one day.
They called the agency, including our European manager, Olaf Schröter. So, and they offered us five gigs in Moscow and five gigs in Leningrad.
So we went there, we had everything with us, our PA system, our gear, you know, the drums, the guitars, everything. We took our trucks, we even took our own cook.
We invested like 500,000. Our financial guy, who said, you guys must be crazy to do that because you never get this money back. We said, you know, when we do this kind of concerts in Leningrad, we want to show the Russians really what rock music is all about. And we're not standing here with one Marshall speaker and whatever.
I remember flying there for the first time. I'm sitting in the plane thinking, my God, when you're going to land there now, they're going to arrest you and put you to Siberia. And there you will rot in the way for the rest of your life.
We didn't know exactly what to expect. But on the other hand, it was what you sort of expected. It was cold, it was gray, it was the Soviet Union, you know, like the way we were told it's going to look like.
Arriving in Russia was for me like a dream comes true.
The welcome was so warm, so much welcome, hardly any passport controls. We went directly into the diplomatic sector. There was a big buffet there with caviar and vodka outside. The limousines were waiting. We were really treated like superstars there.
We had a support band called Gorky Park. Gorky Park came on stage when we did a sound check and were a little bit upset with their management and said, you know, guys, what can we do? We want to play, but we don't have any equipment because our management, put us down by not delivering what we need for the show. Then we said to them, look, you can look what you want to have, and we give you that. So that was the beginning of a friendship with Gorky Park, and that was good for us as well, because we were hanging out with them. We learned how close the Russian soul is to us.
After we performed the first night in front of 20,000 people at the arena in Leningrad, we were told that our concerts in Moscow were canceled. And I think the main reason was probably because it was the end of April, very close to the 1st of May, the day of labor in Russia, one of the most celebrated days in Russia. It was still communistic then in 88. So they canceled the 5 concerts in Moscow, I think for that reason, and we played 10 shows in Leningrad, all sold out. It was an amazing experience.
It was adventurous, really adventurous.
For us, it was very important to play there because 1 year later we played the Moscow Peace Festival and we noticed already the changes over 1 year coming with this special plane over to Moscow and then seeing the changes. Of course, there was already one thing in the air. There is a new dimension in the air. And Klaus took it and put it into Wind of Change.
Again, I wrote the lyrics there together with Klaus Meiner. And with Rudolf, we wrote the song as another Schenker Meiner rare bell song. And don't stop at the top, as the lyrics say. You know, when you are at the top, this is not the time to stop. Then you have to think, how can I stay at the top? And maybe I can even reach newer heights, you know, with new things. So this song is also a positive message to the fans, you know. Don't stop at something because now you think you have it all. There's always a reason to go on to next adventures, to the next heights, and so on.
I remember when we did Love at First Sting in Stockholm, there was our agent, Nick Harris, and he always said something like, hey guys, there's no limit, there's no limit. So, and when I composed this riff there and the song, Klaus immediately used the possibility and said, okay, there's always a new beginning, there's never an end. And don't stop at the top, because there was like a forcing us to get even bigger, higher, and make it even use a new top.